Hello my dear students, welcome again. Today we will start with the new lesson, lesson number 3, natural resources. Now children, let me tell you what do we mean by resources. Now children, now I am delivering a lecture. I am using blackboard, I am using slides. So these are the resources for you at a time. Yes or no children? So resources are the things which we use in our day-to-day life. Now, the lesson which we are going to study is about natural resources. Now, what do you mean by natural resources? The word natural says that the resources which we get from the nature are called natural resources. Now children, which resources do we get from the nature? Air, water, sunlight, soil, forest, yes or no, wildlife. So these are the resources which we get from the nature. Children, you know, every day in our life, we are using these natural resources. So, natural resources are gift to us which is given by the nature. Early humans did not know how to use these natural resources. So, gradually and gradually, they learn to harness them and make them into the useful things which make their life easy and easier. More and more is which made their life more and more easier. Now children, nowadays rainy season is going on. We see waterfalls everywhere. Yes or no children? See our nature, how beautiful it is. So children, the waterfalls, which they are also the gift of nature to us. But until and unless, you know children, this waterfall has a very great force. But until and unless we use these waterfalls to generate electricity, they are of no use. Same way children, other resources like air, water, sunlight, until and unless we make their proper use, until and unless we convert them into the valuable things, they are of no use. Yes or no children? So sunlight, which is available to us every day in abundance, but until and unless we trap the sunlight and we make use of that sunlight, it is of no use. Further, we are going to study how to use these resources. But first of all, let us talk about the natural resources. So children, did you understand what are natural resources? So natural resources are the resources which are available to us by the nature. For example, air, water, sunlight, wildlife. Yes or no children? Even the minerals also. The we use coal, petrol, diesel every day in our life. They are also our natural resources. Now children, we are still unaware of some of the resources and we are not able to convert them. We are not able to convert them into the usable things. Even though the resources are available in abundance, but still some of the countries have not utilized them properly and so they are economically backward. Now, why some of the countries have not utilized them properly? Because, do you remember in 4th standard we have studied about the human resource? What do you mean by human resource? That for a well-developed country, we need efficient and skilled human resource. Means skilled means the people should be well educated, well skilled to utilize these resources. Yes or no children? Natural resources are available, but until and unless we know how to convert them, so who convert them into the valuable products? Good human resource, skilled and efficient human resource. So there, some of the countries are unable to utilize them properly, are unable to utilize utilize them properly, and so they are economically backward. Now children, so this is about the natural resources. Let us move towards the another part, that is classification of natural resources. Now children, resources are classified into two parts, living resources and non-living resources, that is renewable resources and non-renewable resources. In your textbook, it is mentioned living resources or biotic resources, and the another one is non-renewable resources, that is abiotic resources. Now children, let us see what are renewable resources or living. Now children, let us first talk about the living resources. Now living resources are the resources which can generate if the conditions are favorable. For example, crops, wildlife, forest, all these things can generate if the conditions are favorable. Crops can grow, so they are inexhaustible resources. These living resources, biotic means the resources which have life in them, they can generate after a period of time, and so they are called renewable resources. Now children, when we take the example of fossil fuels, coal, petrol, and when we talk about these fossil fuels, they can generate, but children, these fossil fuels take millions and millions of years to form again. Actually they are renewable, but because they take millions of years, millions and millions of years, for us they are non-renewable resources. Now children, air, water, sunlight, land, are they going to exhaust from our earth? No, they will never get exhaust from the earth. So they are inexhaustible resources. Okay children, so what are renewable resources? Renewable resources are the resources which will never get exhaust from the earth. Okay, and non-renewable resources are the resources, they have in your textbook the term non-living resources, abiotic, which don't have life in them. So non-renewable resources are the resources which will get exhaust from the earth one day. So children, this is about the classification of the natural resources. For today, natural resources and classification of natural resources.